What's the deals, everybody? What is the deals? It's your boy, Emilio Gambino. Welcome to Emilio Duran's place, where I talk about and display various things. How everybody doing out there? This is my dining area. It's my dining area, right? But I just wanted to come and talk to y'all real quick. About to go see Speak No Evil. Hopefully it's a good movie. So I'm gonna record my experience. I'm gonna show y'all what movie theater I'm going to. And then after the movie, I'm gonna come to y'all and I'm gonna give y'all my honest opinion about the movie. I said to myself, this should be a new segment of mine where I go to movie theaters and experience the theater, tell y'all about the theater I went to, give the theater my review, and also give the movie my review, okay? So the theater that I'm about to head to is in Jesup, Georgia, and I'm going to put some pictures and video on here so y'all can see what the theater looks like, and I'm going to give it my honest grade and also see the movie Speak No Evil. It looks very interesting. It's a thriller, drama, thriller, and suspense. That's what it said in the trailer. Of course, I'm gonna give the description of the theater I'm going to and the description of the movie that I'm about to go see. All right, so I'm about to get in my vehicle, head to the movie theater. Simbi's gonna be there, her sister Sade gonna be there, and their mother Linda's gonna be there. So we're gonna experience it. We're gonna get some snacks, some popcorn, and yeah, we're gonna just experience it. And I'm going to share it with the masses and just give y'all my honest opinion on the movie itself, the movie theater, shoot, even the snacks and stuff. Why not, right? So I'm about to head on out. This is my home. And yeah, I'm excited, man. This is going to be one of my new segments. Movie reviews, but only at the theater, so I can give y'all picture and video of the actual movie theater itself, and I could give you picture and video of the new movie that's coming out. Not too much, because I don't want to get in trouble. Just small clips, and of course whatever's out there for the world to see with the trailer. Okay, so I appreciate y'all, I love y'all. And we're going to get into it, man. Peace. All right, what's going on, everybody? So I made it to Jesup, to this very historic theater. The theater is very, very historic. It says it's celebrating its 100-year celebration, 1924 to 2024. And it's a very, very historic-looking movie theater. That's it right there behind me, y'all. You see it? That's it right there behind me. So we're gonna go in there, do a little video, do a little couple of pictures, see what it looked like. But I'm in historic downtown Jesup, as you can see. It's very old school, very historic, very small community. All right. So we're going to go in here and check it out and plus see the movie. All right, y'all. Peace. Thank you.
I'm
about to see the movie. I think it's great. There they go. There they go. The Simi Wimby. And we're gonna get it in. Alright y'all, so I just finished watching the movie. Very nice movie theater. It gives it a old school type of vibe. I'm going to give my opinion and my reaction to the movie tomorrow. I'm gonna let it process in my brain, think about it, because I don't like to just give a reaction as soon as I finish watching it, because you know you might give a improper review or reaction because you just finished watching the movie. You know, you might be like, yeah, woo, you know, the adrenaline is pumping, your hype. So I'm gonna marinate on it, think about it, listen to it again. Well, not listen to it, but think about it. Maybe read some of the information about the movie and like watch a trailer or something so I could get back in my brain. And then after that, I should be good to go. All right. It's the movie theater. All right. Heading back to the crib. Later. What's the deals? It's your boy Emilio Gambino. Welcome to Emilio Duran's place, where I talk about and display various things. Good morning, how is everybody doing? September 19th, 11:20 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. What's going on? So I'm reviewing the movie Speak No Evil. And I saw it yesterday. I went all the way to Jesup, Georgia, to this historic movie theater. But before we get into the movie theater, let me talk about the movie. So I'm very, very hard in critiquing and grading movies. I like to know the who, what, where, why, and how. The realism of the movie. The action. Is it slow? The drama. The suspense. All that stuff. And the movie started out slow. Looked like they were either in like Italy or Greece. It was somewhere in Europe where it's a lot of countryside, a lot of grass, trees, woods, forests, right? Way out there where the population in the town is probably like 2,000 or something like that. So it's like way out there. It looks very beautiful, very earthy, very, you know, you're out there with nature, a lot of hills and playing fields. Very beautiful. I do not know what country they were in, but it's definitely somewhere in Europe, that's for sure. Like a Greece, Italy, Ireland, something like that. And there was this couple on vacation, and the couple consists of a young daughter, a husband, and a wife. And they were just on vacation for the weekend, chilling, and they bumped into a couple. And the couple was a man, a wife, and a boy. And they were having conversation because, you know, they don't know each other. So they just, you know, they see each other at the restaurant. Hey, how you doing, sir? Hey. But the couple with the crazy guy, he's very animated. So he draws attention to himself, right? He's animated. Like, he's at the restaurant. He's talking loud. He's all over the place. So, you know, as a bystander, you're going to look and be like, what's up with this guy? He's so animated. But the husband liked that. You know, he's like, oh, you seem like a cool dude. So the psychopath, he already knows in his brain what he's trying to do because he's a psychopath, right? And fast forward a little bit, the psychopath's MO is to find a little girl, because like I said, he has a wife, he has a son, but he doesn't have a daughter. He wants to have a complete package, you know, the traditional complete package: wife, husband, daughter, son. So he sees the couple and he preys on them, basically, right? So they having dinner, they talking, and he's like, hey man, you should come to the crib where I live at, so you can experience where I am, the countryside. And the husband's like, yeah, yeah. The wife, she's not too sure about it, right? Because they're strangers. You just don't pop up to a stranger's crib. Well, not pop up. You just don't go to a stranger. This is the first time you met this person in your life, right? So fast forward, that vacation's over, their home. The husband is like, man, maybe we should go to the countryside and, you know, see what it's like. And the wife is like, they strange. I don't know them people. I'm not going over there. So the husband was kind of disgruntled. So the wife was like, all right, come on, let's go. Call him up. Husband calls him up. Yo, we coming through. Cool. They go out there. Mind you, it's the countryside. So like, their nearest neighbor is probably like 30 miles away. When I'm talking about country, I'm talking about your house is in the middle of nowhere. Woods, trees, grass, plains, cliffs. Nowhere. You probably got to drive an hour to the local town just to get some milk and cheese. See what I'm saying? So they out there. And everything seemed pretty cool for like the first day. But the second day, the wife, she was really picking up on things. The husband, he's a sorry lost cause as a man and a husband. And that was one of the things I really didn't like about the movie, because why they portrayed a man so soft? I don't like that. I don't like that. See? And that's you have to start decoding movies too, because there's messages, hidden agendas in movies. Like, stop trying to make the husband some punk, some softy. I don't appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? He all frail and stuff. I don't like that. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, fast forward a little bit. The wife see what's going on, and the little boy that's with the psycho family, he can't talk because his tongue is cut out. But he's trying to communicate with the little girl, like, yo, these people are crazy, they dangerous. And a matter of fact, they kidnapped me. I'm not even their kid. They killed my parents, and I'm now their child. So when the little daughter found out, she told the mom. The mom took pictures. Well, the daughter took pictures, showed to the mom. The mom told the husband. The dad, he all scary and all this stuff. Like, yo, come on. Listen, your family's in danger. It's time to step up to the plate. No, he's scary and all this sensitive feminine crap. Yo, when your family's in danger and it's time to step up, man, it is what it is, man. Killer be killed. Okay? That modern life is gone. It's medieval times. All right? So, fast forward. The Cycle family found out they know what's up. Right? And now, they trying to kill the feminine man and the masculine wife. Right? Because he's soft and she's hardcore. Right? So, mind you now, she doing all the killing. He ain't kill a single person. Let me repeat that. She doing all the killing. He ain't kill a single person. All right? She killed everybody. He didn't. The movie itself was pretty good. It was a good story. Started off slow, picked up at the end. You understood why things was going on, how things was going on, where it was going on, right? So, honestly, I'm a hard grader, like I said. And I really look into the movie for entertainment and also what's the message. And in the real world, if I was there, the realism, what the movie's trying to portray, what's the hidden message? I don't like that feminine man shit. I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't like it. We didn't really get a background on why the guy was the way he was. All he said was, you know, I ain't have a good upbringing. I mean, there's a lot of people who have a good upbringing and they normal people. If they could have just gave a little backstory on that instead of just, I have a normal upbringing, whatever. But very realistic things were going on in the movie. So I gave the movie 3 stars out of 5. Like I said, it's a good movie. And I enjoyed it. I did, besides the feminine husband. But it was pretty good. Then the movie theater itself, right? So it's a historic town. Matter of fact, they celebrating their 100th birthday of the movie theater. Very historic. If you're into that type of stuff, the historic, that's cool. Me personally, it's all right. But everything is so old school and out of date. Like when I say the building's historic, it's historic. The bathroom needs remodeling. The screen and the theater was small. The seats were okay. I give the movie theater 2 stars out of 5. They need a lot of up-to-date things in there, but I understand they're trying to keep that historic feel, that historic look. So that's cool. I definitely will go back there again to watch another movie and to do a critique. But the movie theater gets 2 stars and the movie itself get 3. Like, share, subscribe to the channel. Let me know what y'all think. Leave a comment. If y'all seen the movie, tell me how y'all feel about the movie as well. All right, I'm out of here. Peace.